and that was scary to me. And he was holy. That was also scary. And in fact, some of the people in the little churches my dad pastored who represented themselves as holy were some of the people you really didn't want to be around. I wasn't sure I wanted to be holy. And if you received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you got it. So the Holy Spirit wasn't a person, he was an it. And I remember in one of the churches my dad pioneered when I was a kid, dad gave me the responsibility of being a janitor. And I had the job of cleaning the church. It was just me and the Holy Ghost. It scared me spitless. But Jesus called him the Comforter. You know, the word is paraclete. It means one called alongside. It's used in the Greek language for someone who in a court of law would vouch for the reputation and the character of someone else. In the Latin, it comes from the word, the English word comes from the Latin, comfortus. Fortus, from the word fort, or filled with bravery, come with. So the Holy Spirit makes us brave. He comes alongside of us. And it's very easy to miss this word out of Jesus' lips when he says in John chapter 14, verse 16, I will ask the Father, and he will send you another comforter. In other words, Jesus says of himself, I also am the paraclete. I am the comforter. But he says, I will send you another one. And in the language of the New Testament, there are two words for another, whereas in English, we only have one word. One word for another is the word allos, which means of the same kind. And the other word is heteros, from which we get heterogeneity and a few other things that begin with the prefix hetero. Hetero means another of a different kind. When Jesus says, I am going to send you another comforter, he uses the word allos, another of the same kind. In other words, Jesus is saying, I'm going to send you someone just like me. And don't you want to get close to Jesus? Because you know that Jesus is your friend. And just as Jesus is your friend, so is the Holy Spirit our friend. Like Jesus says, I've no longer called you servants, I have called you friends. My friends love me. It's always amazing to me that they do. They love me, they believe in me, they support me, write me nice notes, they encourage me. And they often tell me the truth about myself. Sometimes truth I don't want to hear, quite frankly. Holy Spirit is our friend. And time and again in your life and in mine, he has demonstrated his friendship to us, sometimes when we weren't even aware of it. I got thinking I was preparing this message, and I got to thinking about an experience, and it just